Hi there, let's talk about structure chart. So for this video, we're learning on the purpose of a structure chart, how to construct a structure chart for a given problem, as well as derive equivalent pseudocode from a structure chart. First of all, let's look at the purpose of a structure chart. It's actually used in structured programming to arrange program modules, and each module is represented by a box. And next, programmer must document on the diagram the data items which are needed for each stage, and data items which are then passed on to subsequent stages. So looking at the definition, you might not understand what it means, but no worries. Let's look at a practical example to understand better. So first of all, we have this car price calculator program here. And the first module will be input car data. So just looking at the module name, we know that this module actually inputs some car data into this car price calculator program. So what will be the inputs? The input will be the mileage, the registration date, as well as the price paid. So these are the data items needed. So if you look at this, we have this arrow here with the data item name. And the next module will be calculate selling price. So this is a second-hand car dealer. It means that you'll buy the used car from the public and then maybe improve it or clean it or just repair it and then sell at a higher price to the public. So what will be the input for the module calculate selling price? It will be the mileage, the price paid, as well as the registration date. So what will be the output for this module? It will be the sell price. So this is the input arrow going into the module, and this is the output arrow coming out from the module. It means that for this module, you'll take these three data items and then to calculate the output, which is the sell price. And the last module will be output sale price. So what will be the input for this output sales price module? Definitely the input will be just the sell price. Therefore, this is how you can construct a structure chart. And now let's look at a more complicated structure chart example. So let's look at this example. Create a structure chart which input the radius of a sphere, calculate and output either the volume or the surface area. The algorithm will repeat until a radius of 0 is entered. It means that for this program, we'll take in radius as an input and then we'll calculate either the volume or the surface area. And then we'll just keep repeating the calculation until a radius of 0 is entered into the program. So let's just get started on drawing the structure chart. So first of all, we'll write the name of the program, which is the volume and surface area calculator. And then we have this arrow here, until radius is equal to 0. So it means that this program is a loop and we will just keep repeating until we input radius is equal to 0. Now let's look at the first module, which is input radius. So what will be the data item for this module? Definitely it will just be the radius. And next will be the calculate module. So what will be the input to this calculate module? It will be radius. And what will be the output for this calculate module? It will be the answer. And under the calculate module, we have to either calculate the volume or the surface area. So let's look at how can we do that. So first of all, we have this volume here. So it means that for this program, we are asking, are we calculating volume? So if it's the true, we will just calculate volume. So this is the calculate volume module. And then what will be the input to this module? It will be the radius. And then what will be the output? The output will be just the answer. And then if the volume is false, we will just calculate the surface area. And what will be the input to this module? It will be just the radius, and the output will be just the answer. And the last module will be output answer. And what will be the input to this module? It will be just the answer. Therefore, this is how you can create a structure chart based on this practice example. And now let's look at how can we convert this structure chart into pseudocode. So if you look at this slide here, I have this structure chart on the right here, so that we can always refer back to a structure chart as we go through the pseudocode. So let's go through together. So the first line will be declare radius real. Since radius can be decimal, therefore the data type is real. And next, declare answer as real. Since the answer can be decimal as well, therefore we declare answer as real. And next will be constant pi is equal to 3.142. So what this assignment does is that we are just assigning 3.142 into this variable called pi. And this is a constant. It means that we will never change or update the value of this pi variable here. And next we'll be creating either the function or procedure based on the module defined in the structure chart. So let's start with calculate volume module. So function calculate volume radius real returns real. It means that the input will be radius. So this is the input here. And the answer will be a real number as well. And what is inside this function? It will be, first of all, return 4 over 3 times pi times r times r times r. So this is the formula to calculate the volume of a sphere, which is 4 over 3 times pi r cubed. Then we will just end the function. And next we'll be calculating the surface area. So let's look at this. Function calculate surface area, radius real returns real. So as usual, the input will be radius here, and then we'll be returning a real number. And then what will be inside the function? It will just be return 4 times pi times r times r. So this is the formula to calculate the surface area of a sphere, which is 4 pi r squared. And then we will just end the function. So we have done this calculate volume module and we have done this calculate surface area module. Now let's just do input radius module. So how do you do this? so first of all, let's look at this procedure input radius. It means that we are not returning anything from this module. Therefore, we are using procedure. And next will be output, please enter the radius of the sphere. So you can imagine we have this console and then it will just display, please enter the radius of the sphere. So you just enter the radius of the sphere into the console. And next, input radius. So whatever that we type into the console will be stored into this radius variable. So we have declared this variable at the top here. So declare radius as real. And next will be, while radius is less than zero, do output please enter a positive number. So it means that if someone types in a negative radius into the console, we will be just asking please enter a positive number so that we can get a positive radius instead of a negative radius. So next will be input radius, which means that we'll be taking the input again. And then we'll just end the while loop and finally end the procedure. So for this part one, we have done this input radius, calculate volume, calculate surface area, as well as declaring the variables. Now let's look at part two. So first of all, procedure output answer. So this is for this module here. And then the procedure is quite straightforward. We will just write output answer and then end the procedure. And now let's start with the program. So first of all, we will call this procedure here. So we will call input radius. So we have created this procedure in part one. Definitely, if you forget what the procedure does, definitely just scroll back the video to look at what is inside this input radius procedure. And next will be loop for this structure chart here. So what will be the loop? It will be while loop. So while radius is not equal to zero. So this is the symbol for not equal. And then output, do you want to calculate the volume V or surface area S? So it means that if you want to calculate the volume, you just type V into the console. And if you want to calculate the surface area, you will just type S into the console. And next will be input reply. It means that whatever that you type into the console will be stored into this variable called reply. If reply is equal to string V, then it means that let's say we want to calculate the volume, we will just type V into the console. And what the code does is that answer is equal to calculate volume radius. It means that we'll trigger this calculate volume function here by passing in the radius here. So remember that we have got this radius from this input radius procedure here. So what we do here is that we will just pass the radius into this function right now. So calculate volume, we'll pass in the radius here to calculate the answer. And then we will output volume and space. It means that later on, we'll just output answer beside this volume here. And then else, answer is equal to calculate surface area radius here. It means that let's say we type in S into the console, we will just calculate the surface area. Definitely, if you type in A, B, C, D, E, F, G, anything except V, it will actually just calculate surface area as well. But to make this example less complicated, we'll just take the else for now. And next will be output surface area space. So it will be surface area space answer in the end. And next, and if, and then call output answer, which means that we are actually calling this procedure output answer here, which is actually just outputting answer. So what happens is that the output console, it will be something like volume space and then output answer, which is the answer. So it will be volume space answer or surface area space answer. So this is the logic behind the code. And then we will do call input radius again. So remember that this is a loop. We will only stop the loop until radius is equal to zero as the input. And finally for this code, we will just end while. So this is how we can derive pseudo code from a structure chart. Definitely it might not be confusing at first, but no worries, just pause the video, scroll back to part 1, and then go through slowly, and then come back to part 2, and then go through slowly, and refer back to the structure chart. I'm pretty sure you can understand after a while. I hope you have a better understanding of structure chart after going through this video. Definitely if you're taking A-level computer science exam, feel free to check out my video playlist split by chapters or papers by referring to the video description down below, or you can just go to youtube.com/@hagwinschool and click on playlist. And as usual, like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you, and I will see you again then. Bye-bye.